Hey everyone, in this lesson you will learn how to create seamless textures for 3D renders in Photoshop. I have here a brick wall photo that I've downloaded from cgtextures.com. In order to use it as a seamless texture in 3D environment, we need to prepare it first. Start by cropping the photo into square, so it will be easier to work with in 3D. Position the crop borders on elements in the photo that could simplify the task of tiling. For instance, I'll set the top border on the middle of this brick line and the bottom border on the middle as well. Note how the bricks at the top and the bottom borders are aligned. This will help us in the next step. Let's make this texture seamless by going to Filter, Other, Offset. Move the horizontal and vertical sliders to place the seams in the center. The new borders can now be tiled from side to side and top to bottom. But we still have to fix these horizontal and vertical seams. You can use the clone stamp tool for this job. Press Alt plus click to pick the target. Start with a corner or an edge. Try to use a small brush and retouch as little as you can. Repeat this process along the seams. Take the time to do this well so it wouldn't be visible at all. It's important not to go too close to the edge or they wouldn't tile correctly. Next, we need to balance the brightness of the texture. It may be hard to see, but the top part of the image is a bit too dark than the bottom part. To fix this, duplicate the layer and go to Filter, Other, High Pass. Set a radius of about 80 to 100. Now go to Edit, Fade High Pass. Switch to Luminosity mode and leave the opacity at 100. This is the before and after. The overall brightness looks the same now. I'll merge down these layers and rename the new one as base texture. Another problem that we need to remove is the shadows produced by cracks and bumps on the brick surface. For that, we're going to use the high pass filter again. Duplicate the layer and apply high pass filter. This time, use a small radius to capture the contrasty edges of the image. Change the blend mode to luminosity. And reduce the opacity. Merge the layers once more. Our final step will be to color correct the texture. Click on Hue and Saturation and reduce the yellow saturation. Next, I'll change the hue and saturation of the bricks by selecting the red color. You can play with that as you see fit. Save the texture as a PNG or a JPEG file. If you wish to create other maps from these textures, such as displacement, bump, and reflection, just click here.